This episode is made possible by Target and Adventure Academy.
Wild Kratts! In the equatorial regions of the Americas, on islands in the Caribbean Sea, the salty marshes are home to a beautiful and bizarre bird, the Caribbean flamingo. Hey, it's us, the Kratt brothers. I'm Martin. I'm Chris. And we're going to get an up-close and personal look at the amazing Caribbean flamingo by heading to a conservation sanctuary that specializes in water birds. Sylvan Heights Bird Park in North Carolina. This is the unmistakably pink flamingo. Flamingos love to stick together. They're very social birds that live in flocks or colonies. The colonies can get massive, with thousands of flamingos living together. Flamingos are never far from water. That's because they're wading birds who feed on small plants and animals in the water. Flamingos have specialized features that fit their water-loving lifestyle. The legs of the flamingo are perfect for wading. They're stilt-like and super thin and long enough so they can walk around in pretty deep water. And I love the neck of the flamingo. It's super long too, so they can reach all the way down to their toes. So how do flamingos get their food? Well, that's the job of one of my favorite flamingo features of all, that awesome one-of-a-kind beak. Flamingos have such cool features, but the big question is, why are flamingos pink? Where does that amazing color come from? Imagine if we had the creature powers of the flamingo to find out. What if? Mystery of the Flamingo's Pink.
Aviva, wake up! You gotta see this!
¿Qué pasa?
Can you believe that pink color? It's gorgeous, right?
It's amazing! What a beautiful pink!
Aviva, you're not even looking at it. The sun rises that way.
Yeah, but the flamingos are that way.
Wow!
Here they are, Jimmy. This salt marsh is the home of the Caribbean flamingo, one of six different flamingos in the world. Check out that cool hooked beak, the long S-shaped neck, the brilliant pink feathers, and the legs that...
What? There's only one leg? It's a one-legged flamingo!
Jimmy, it's okay. He has two legs. See? Flamingos like to stand on one leg. It's efficient because it uses less energy, and they even sleep standing on one leg. Woo-hoo! Check it out. I call it the flamingo pose. This takes years to perfect it. Oh, up! And you need more practice. Yeah, this water is salty. Ooh. Hey, where are you going? Oh, to her nest. They make them out of mud with a few stones, some straw, and feathers. And look, one super cute chick. Hello, little buddy.
But he's white. Isn't he supposed to be pink? And his beak is straight. You sure he's a flamingo?
Positive. Those features will come as he grows up. I'm gonna name you...
Pinkster. You'll grow into the name.
Both a mom and dad work together to raise their chick.
taking care of the egg, protecting the chick, and feeding them.
Really?
What? I'm hungry.
Well, too many chips aren't good for you. Try an apple or something.
No, thanks. Chips for me.
I know. He's a loud muncher.
Okay, Aviva. Feather loaded in DNA analyzer.
Perfect. That'll give me all the genetic coding I need to start a flamingo creature power suit.
Make sure you put plenty of pink in those suits. Forget the blue and the green this time.
For sure. You can't have a flamingo creature power suit without the pink. Pink!
Oh, yes! I do believe I've found the perfect source for a fantastic new seasoning. The secret new ingredient is in this salty, briny water. I'll just run some through my purification filter. Add to stir fry. Perfection! I don't know what kinds of salty goodies are in this water, but I know I'm gonna bottle the stuff and make a lot of moolah. Old Zacky'll be jealous.
Whoa, Pinkster! You stand on one leg better than me. And you're only a week old. Ooh, here's your mom.
Martin, check it out. It's feeding time.
Yeah, she makes a milky liquid in her esophagus and feeds it to her chick. Whoa, that's so cool.
Excuse me, pardon me, coming through.
Excuse us. Sorry to bother you. Don't mean to ruffle any feathers.
Guys, we did it!
Flamingo Creature Power Disc, ready for action!
Yes! All right! Is it going to be pink?
Of course!
Woohoo!
Yes!
Me first! It's mine! Whoa! No, it's mine! Got it!
Okay, you first. Thanks, bro. Insert Flamingo Power Disc. Touch Flamingo and activate Flamingo Power! Flamingo Power! Oh, I feel so white! A white flamingo? Who ever heard of a white flamingo? This is a horrible creature power suit malfunction.
What happened to the pink?
We've got a creature mystery here, team. The mystery of the flamingo's pink.
Hey, flamingo guys, mind if I join you? Oh, come on, guys. Oh, okay, so I'm not pink. But everything else is flamingo-y. I got the neck and legs. Ooh, and check this out. Standing on one leg has never been easier.
That's because flamingos actually have a locking mechanism in their leg.
Check this out. With this neck, I can hang my head all the way down to the water. Whoa, things look pretty different from down here. And the world is upside down.
Well, put that upside down thing to use, bro. The flamingos are doing their classic upside down feeding. They swing their heads back and forth through the water as they walk slowly along.
This flamingo beak is even built for upside down feeding. It's smaller on the top and bigger on the bottom. The opposite of many bird beaks. Except when upside down, then everything's right side up. Yeah, I think I've got the move down. But what exactly am I after?
Not sure. Flamingos are filter feeders, so it's something small. But we need to get a closer look. Deploy miniaturizer! Miniaturize!
You sure you want to go that mini?
Got to find out what's in here. Watch this dive, bro.
Woohoo! Uh-oh, I got a little knotted up here.
Oh, wow. This water is really salty. This mineral-filled water is called brine. Blue-green algae. Not many things can live in water this salty, but this algae can. And brine shrimp. Hey, guys, you must love it in here. You pretty much have the place to yourself. Be because it's too salty for most fish and other predators to survive in. And you ate the algae. Nice little life you got here. Okay, quick scan and... Shrimpy Chris to Aviva. Come in, Aviva.
Aviva here. Go, Shrimpy Chris.
I'm sending scans of the creatures I found here. Algae and shrimp. You can...
Look out!
Ah, feeding flamingos! They're going after the algae and the brine shrimp. Uh-oh, we're getting sucked in! Whoa! Oh, he got us into his beak by moving his tongue back and forth quickly and creating a suction. Whoa, up we go! Look at that tongue! Whoa! The little creatures get pushed towards the outside of the beak and get caught in hair-like plates called lamellae. Oh no, he's about to swallow! Gotta get out of here! Safe! Woo! Just missed being a flamingo snack. All right, I'm out of here. See ya! Did you get that, Martin? Got all that, dude, but now, if I could only get out of this knot.
I can help. It's really tight. Wow!
What? Yes! Thanks, Jimmy.
Don't mention it.
Okay, now to try out the old filter system. Ready, Pinkster? Back and forth, 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 back and forth. Ooh. Hey, you can even stomp the ground to stir up more shrimp from the mud? Let me give it a try. Like this. Oh, this is not as easy as it looks. Oh.
Time to test the water. Adding now and analyze. Aviva, look at this. I found something.
What is it?
That's the formula for carotenoids. And the algae and brine shrimp have super high levels of this.
Carotenoids? Sounds like what you get when you cross a carrot with an asteroid.
Not exactly. It's a type of pigment, something responsible for color. And the flamingos' natural foods are loaded with the stuff.
Oh, that sounds like more than a coincidence.
And look, if I isolate the carotenoids in a solution...
Pink! A pinkish pigment! We just might be onto something here.
Hey, Martin, how's the feeding going?
Well, working on it.
Well, pick up the pace. That suit needs to absorb brine shrimp. Lots of them.
Brine shrimp? Really?
Yeah, they just might be the secret to the mystery of the flamingo's pink.
Okay, Pinkster, let's get flamingoing.
Mm-mm, I am a brine shrimp collecting machine.
Why are you slowing down? Keep going.
Can I stop now?
We need more shrimp. Gotta get those carotenoids.
More shrimp. More shrimp. Must eat shrimp.
Must eat shrimp.
Mmm, you're doing good. Keep going, Martin.
So many shrimp, I'm stuffed.
Martin, your face! It's pink!
Pink? Really? It worked! My feathers are pink!
Hooray!
I'm pink, you're pink, we're all pink! Pink, 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 pink!
Awesome!
Wow, the pink color really does come from what the flamingo eats.
Exactly. What you eat is really important, Jimmy.
So flamingos need to eat right to stay healthy and pink. For them, that means brine shrimp, algae, things with carotenoids, of course.
And people need to eat right to stay healthy, too.
Huh. So easy on the junk food. Hey, I have something important to do.
You are what you eat. Flamingos are proof.
Oh, yeah. Woohoo! Loop-de-loop brine shrimp style. So you guys are the secret to the flamingo's pink. Mystery solved. I love you guys.
I do too, Chris. They deserve to have a creature power suit built in their honor.
Sure do. Look at all their feathery legs.
Oh, they're great for swimming through the water. And for tickling, too.
Okay. Okay, I give. And they have eyes on stalks.
Kind of like lobsters. Some people call these guys sea monkeys, but they don't look like monkeys at all.
No, they don't. At all. Okay, I'm grabbing some design tablets. Don't move.
Not going anywhere, Aviva. I'm hanging with these guys for a while. A brine shrimp holiday. Huh? Whoa!
All right, so let's get started on this brine shrimp suit. Chris? Chris? Oh well, at least you guys stuck around.
Hang on, guys! I think we got sucked into some kind of tube! But where does it lead to?
Yes, the perfect briny broth.
Oh no! Gourmand! What is he up to?
I want whatever tasty morsels and minerals are in this water. Let the filters run day and night.
What? No! Ah! Mayday! Mayday! Help! Mayday! Ah!
What? What's happening?
The flamingos!
What about the flamingos?
They're white! They've lost their pink! Me too!
What is going on?
Why are they all white?
Oh, not again.
Now it's the mystery of the disappearance of the flamingo's pink.
Through the filter systems and into the jar, my briny broth concentrate, how delicious you are. Easy to use, just add water and then add it to any meal, then do it again.
Uh-oh. Can't hang on any longer!
Full of tasty morsels.
Morsels? For you? No way! For flamingos, maybe, but not you. Flamingos need their natural food, their nourishment. You guys are part of the natural order and need to be living free and in the wild. Shrimpy Chris to Tortuga. Come in, Tortuga. It's Chris here.
Oh, hey, bro.
Done with your brine shrimp holiday?
We've got trouble with Gourmand. And the Gourmand trouble is he's taken all the shrimp.
We've got trouble with the flamingos, too. They're white.
Ugh, double whammy.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
I think we're all thinking the same thing.
The flamingos aren't getting the nourishment they need because Gourmand is taking all the shrimp.
Without the shrimp, we lose our pink.
We need a plan.
Let's all huddle.
There, loaded and ready to go.
Oh no, he's gonna take off. Where are they?
Not so fast, Gourmand.
You?
Yeah, me and my flamingos. You can't take all the brine shrimp.
Brine shrimp? Is that what's in the water?
Among other things, you can't take them. The flamingos need those brine shrimp too.
Flamingos? Those aren't flamingos. They're not even pink.
Exactly, because you took away the food that makes the flamingos pink.
Food that makes them pink. That's a good one. Ridiculous. What's that? Look, there's a pink gorilla.
What? Where? Wait, I don't see it.
I think he ate your shrimp.
He obviously doesn't know about carotenoids. After him, guys! Even with the long legs and neck, flamingos are awesome flyers. Come on, let's keep up with them, guys.
Huh? So they think they can catch me? I can outfly those skinny birds.
Better hurry with our plan, Aviva. Gourmand's trying to make a getaway.
I'm done. Printing disc now. Brian Shrimp disc ready for teleportation. Jimmy, catch!
Energize and drop it!
Yes! Insert Brine Shrimp Power Disc. Touch Brine Shrimp. Hey, that's easy. And activate Brine Shrimp Power! Oh, Shrimpy Chris isn't so shrimpy anymore.
Huh? Autopilot on. What's going on here? What are you?
A brine shrimp. The ones captured in your briny broth concentrate.
Huh. Well, no one said they had to look good to taste good. Now get off my plane, you little shrimp.
Glad to. But I'm taking my friends.
Oh, no, you don't.
Incoming! Get ready to catch, guys! Got it, Chris! Use your necks! Yeah! Woohoo! Way to flamingo! Keep them coming, brother! On their way, bro!
Gotcha!
Oh, not for long! Brine Shrimp legs tickle! Heads up! Yeah! Nice one, gang!
Oh, whoops!
Last ones!
Nothing to tickle with now!
Uh-oh. Never underestimate a brine shrimp! Yeah. Feather arm tickle power, all ticklers engaged!
I give!
I told you! Never underestimate the best tickle arms on the planet!
Huh?
See ya, Gourmand! Woohoo!
I'll get you next time, Wild Kratts Crouton!
Thanks, Martin.
No problem, Chris.
Back to the salt marsh! Well, that's a creature mission accomplished. All the brine shrimp are safely back home in the salt marsh.
And the flamingos have their healthy food source back. We're pink again!
Pinkster and all the chicks have nutritious food to grow up healthy, strong, and pink.
And I ditched the chips for a whole bunch of foods that are healthy for a human body. Gotta give my body what it needs.
That's great, Jimmy. Hey, I just made a few fun adjustments to the programming of Martin's suit. Try some, Martin.
Oh, okay. How about grapes?
Wow! Cool!
Check this out. Like that one, bro?
Sure do. That's the best one yet.
Well, it's just a fun way to show what the flamingos taught us.
You are what you eat!
Where are the blueberries?
So flamingos get that amazing pink color from the food they eat. And that special beak gives them the amazing creature power of filter feeding. So flamingos can collect tiny shrimp and algae from the water. Oh, I love this awesome hooked beak of the flamingo. And this is a good time to get a close look at those lamellae, those little plate-like filters that you can see right on the edges of the beak. Check it out. This is the filter feeding action of the flamingo. They move their heads side to side as they move their tongue rapidly, rapidly in their beak. You can see if you look at his chin, that tongue action moving. And that pulls water in and out through the filters, collecting the little brine shrimp, the little algae, all the little creatures in the water.
There are no tiny shrimp or algae in my hair, I promise you. They're so small you can hardly see them. But tiny creatures in the water, like brine shrimp and algae, are the reason for the flamingo's pink color. That's because brine shrimp and algae have a special pigment called carotenoids. And when flamingos eat a lot of carotenoids, their feathers turn pink. Without the carotenoids, a flamingo's feathers would be white. The adults, that is. These are lesser flamingo chicks. About 5 weeks old and very cute, kind of funny looking, and no pink. Yeah, as they grow up, their pink color will come in more and more with each new set of feathers until they're perfectly pink as adults. Now, they are getting some of the carotenoids from the crop milk that their parents are feeding them, but it takes a long time for the flamingos to turn pink. Yeah, they are growing fast. Come on, guys, let's go. This way.
Let's go for a walk.
Keep on creature adventuring.
We'll see you on the creature trail.
That's right, come on. Come on, buddy, catch up.
More about cool animals and collect your own Wild Kratts creature powers, go to the Wild Kratts website at pbskids.org. We'll see you there!
Find more of your PBS Kids friends on your local PBS station and the free PBS Kids video app. Also, subscribe to the PBS Kids Prime Video Channel.